it's Sandra. I'm from Madrid and I'm 27 years old and I work in the pharma industry. I've been searching a lot for a group in global health. So once I went to Barcelona, I met some of my colleagues and I just met the previous team in the Global Health Next Generation Network. Well, I work as a medical advisor in the pharma industry, in a pharma focused on immunology. Well, that's a difficult question because then I first started doing a new bachelor in Spain that is called biomedicine, okay? But it's not biology and it's not medicine. So it's in the middle of nowhere somehow. And it was really focused on research and being in the lab. And I started that in Sweden first. I started to know a lot of people, different people from different backgrounds. And then I realized that I was more interested in the global aspects of health rather than the details or more deep research, I will say like that. Mm-hmm. So then that's why I started my master in global health in Barcelona. And then I figured out that pharma industry was a good place to start in my career, and it's been already 3 years that I'm working in the pharma industry. I've been working in GSK for a year and a half, and now in this pharma that is more little, but actually, yeah, it's different, but it's pretty good as well. When it comes to applications, I go through all of the needs or requirements that the company has, or the company or organization. So I want to make sure what they need from me, what they need from whoever is going to have that job. So I try to see some news of the company and so. And just to get a better idea of the, and sometimes I just reach someone that works already in the company, but via LinkedIn or whatever. So I'm like closer to the company because like I can talk to that people and they will just send to me some information, like deeper information about the company and the situation. So I could just be a better fit, I think. That's a tricky question, I think, because like in global health, there are people from different backgrounds. So I think the key point here in global health is networking. That's why, for instance, we are in this group to have a great network of people in love with global health, because actually global health is about everything. It's about all the aspects of the, it's not just about health itself. So in my case, my studies helped me out, having more knowledge about research and having other perspectives in other science, so in other domains. So that's basically what they give to me. Well, I'm interested in sport, interested in psychology as well. Actually, when I was little, I was thinking about doing social psychology, because I'm in love with all these social research. It's really interesting how we behave, right? But like, yeah, I just love reading and other different type of books. And global health means a lot. I mean, it's where it personal and professional comes in. I just love that because basically the most interesting people that I ever met were working in global health in different domains, NGOs or hospitals or whatever. But like we have a common feature somehow, and it's just a lot to me, global health. I think a key feature in global health is being open. And open and interactive. I'm trying to be like a bridge between the different areas and the different specialties or expertise. So I think it's really important to be really tolerant and to really want to know and to feel what the different parts feel and where they interest. And I think that's my purpose and that's what I do in global health. Because for instance, like I wanted to start in an NGO and work there, but now I'm working in the pharma industry and there's a lot of stigma around this area. And actually you have to get in to know what it's about and to know all the different interests, because at the end of the day, it's the patient and it's people what it matters the most. So I think, yeah, that's what I bring to global health. It's a path. It's not an easy path. Because there's so much you could just like work on, and it works when you are honest to yourself. When you're honest to yourself and you just manage to be okay with your interests and being okay with making a difference. Because I guess everyone that works in global health wants to make a difference and wants to in health, basically. So you have to be really open and really honest to yourself. And I think no matter what happens, maybe now in this moment you feel that it's horrible. I mean, I felt that way and I don't know what to do right now with my life. I just finished my master. I'm just like doing this, doing that. And you just like, oh my God, I don't know what to do. But stay there, relax. I mean, doesn't matter if you are gonna work in Coca-Cola or McDonald's for a period of time until you figure out what do you want to do. But if you keep on doing and meeting people, you will finally get your feet. And in my case, I've been just working for 3 years in the pharma industry, but I guess I will change company, I will change of domain. So you have to really be honest to yourself and open.